Hare Krishna. Intelligence is seen not just in aptitude, but also in activity. Nowadays, when people want to know how intelligent someone is, you may do IQ tests. And IQ tests indicate how much a person can analyze, can process, can contextualize. So, basically, information processing ability is what is provided by the IQ scores. But in this kind of analysis of intelligence, intelligence is primarily seen as an aptitude. Okay, how much ability does one have? Which is valid, which is valuable, but at the same time, that alone is not intelligence. A person may have very high IQ, but then functionally, that person might be very arrogant and not be able to get along with people. That person might be addicted and might be destroying oneself by taking self-destructive materials into their bodies. So intelligence is seen not just in the aptitude that we have, but also in the activities that we do. And the Bhagavad Gita talks about intelligence in the 18th chapter. And there it says in 18.30, pravrittim cha nivrittim cha karya karye bhaya bhaye bandham moksham cha yaveti buddhi sa partha satviki. It says that what pravrittim cha nivrittim cha, what is to be done and what is not to be done. Karya karye bhaya bhaye, that this action is, one should be afraid of doing this, one should not do this. And this action, even if it is difficult, still one should not fear doing it, one should persevere doing it. Bandham moksham chaya vetti, one understands, this will lead to bondage, this will lead to freedom. So, to see our actions in terms of their consequences. Okay, what consequence is this action going to lead to? That is an aspect of intelligence. And therefore, we need to see who is intelligent, not just based on the grades they have in their tests, but also in the way they live their life. Ultimately, intelligent people who cannot live properly, who hurt others or hurt themselves, are actually a far greater danger to society than similar people who are not so intelligent. But intelligent people who also act positively, act constructively, who use their intelligence to benefit others and benefit themselves, those are the best people. The Bhagavad Gita says such intelligence, which is centered on choosing the right course of action, is intelligence in the mode of goodness. And that is the intelligence that the Bhagavad Gita provides Arjuna. And through Arjuna, the Bhagavad Gita provides that intelligence to all of us. Studying the Bhagavad Gita may not improve our IQ score, but it will improve our life score. It will help us to choose actions that help us create a better life for ourselves, in this life as well as the next. Thank you. Hare Krishna.